Good morning, students. How are you? It's very nice to meet you, my lovely students. Do you still remember our previous topics? Yes? It was about getting someone's attention. Now, I'm still talking about the same topic, getting someone's attention. Please look at the dialogue one. The dialogue one is the conversation between the teacher and the students. Everybody, may I have your attention, please? Yes, ma'am. From now on, we will use English in the English class, okay? We will use English in our English class. Siti, what did I say? We will use English in our English class. Right. From now on, we will use English in the English class. Everybody, what do you think? Are you ready? Yes, ma'am. What do you think, Edo? Are you ready? Yes, ma'am. I'm ready. Now, we go to the dialogue 2. The dialogue 2 is the conversation between Hesti and Mr. Kian. Excuse me, Dad. Are you busy now? No. What's up, dear? I would like to go hiking, but I need you to sign this letter. Let me see. Here it is, Dad. It will be held next week. Are you sure you are fit enough? You have just recovered from the illness. Yes, Dad. I'm totally fine. Sorry, it will be a long journey and I'm not sure you are fit enough. I can't allow you go. Now, let's identify what expressions for getting someone's attention are used in the dialogue. The first expression is, everybody, may I have your attention, please? This expression is for getting someone's attention. Next expression is Siri, Siti. And then everybody, then Edo. Beside the expression everybody, may I have your attention please? Calling someone's name like Siti, Edo, and we say everybody, semuanya. And then after we call someone's name, we will talk something. It means that we are asking for someone's attention. Next, the expression of getting someone's attention from the dialogue 2 is excuse me, Dad. So by saying excuse me, it means that you are getting someone's attention. Okay, students, besides the expressions are used in the dialogue above, I want to present other expressions for getting someone's attention. You can see all of the expression in the first column, and then in the second column are their purpose. I start with this expression. Excuse me. Or excuse me, please. The most commonly way of getting someone's attention. It is used in a variety of situations. Ini ungkapan untuk meminta perhatian yang paling umum dan bisa digunakan dalam berbagai situasi. Next, may I have your attention? Can I have your attention? It is used to get someone's attention of a group of people who are talking among themselves to make an announcement. Ungkapan ini digunakan untuk meminta perhatian dari sekelompok orang yang sedang berbicara gitu. Jadi semacam untuk membuat pengumuman. Next, attention please. It is used to introduce official announcements, especially over a loudspeaker. Nah, yang ini ungkapan yang sering digunakan di bandara, di stasiun. Biasanya untuk memperkenalkan pengumuman resmi dan biasanya memakai pengeras suara atau mikrofon. Next, look here. It is used to get someone's attention to something of which you disapprove. Option, indignant. Nah, yang ini meminta, look here, lihat sini. Lihat sini. Nah, ini biasanya untuk meminta perhatian seseorang tentang sesuatu yang sedikit menjengkelkan. Ya. Next. Just a minute. It is used to someone who is going away before you think he should or still have something to tell him or to stop someone in the middle of what he is saying in order to voice an objection. Nah, ini digunakan biasanya ketika orang mau pergi gitu, tapi belum menyampaikan apa yang harus dia katakan atau kamu masih ingin mengatakan sesuatu. Bisa juga untuk menyela pembicaraan seseorang di tengah-tengah pembicaraannya gitu, untuk mengajukan sebuah keberatan. Next, hey, it is used whether to express indignations or to warn people quickly of some danger. It is used simply to get attention. It is rude or at least familiar. Nah, yang ini biasanya untuk mengungkapkan memperingatkan orang dengan cepat tentang suatu bahaya. Dan ini sedikit agak kasar gitu ya. Next, look, what's up? Ini juga ungkapan untuk mengungkapkan atau meminta perhatian. Biasanya sering dipakai pada notis atau pemberitahuan, karena tujuannya adalah untuk to warn someone of danger, memperingatkan seseorang tentang bahaya. The last expression is mine, meaning of-nya be careful of, jadi meminta seorang untuk berhati-hati. Okay, students, that's all of my explanations. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.